Hey there, Andy Parker with Lucid Equipment. We have an EPK I7010 we're going to test for you. It's got serial number UA010184 and it was manufactured in 2016. What we're going to do is we're going to run through some of the buttons, not all of them. If you need anything in particular tested, just call us and we're happy to either make another video for you or do a video inspection, you know, video call, what have you, whatever you like. The unit is in perfect condition. There are no blemishes. So let's just run through it. It's set up. It's on iScan. Right now it's set to 3. We've set it to 4. Set it to 1. Set it to 5. Whatever. I'll leave it at 3, C, set it 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, whatever. 3, T, red, leave it off. OE mode 1 is going to make some noise. Now we're going to hear kind of grunt. iScan profile. iScan, we can turn it on and off. iScan 1, iScan 2, you can't see the screen, but it is making the changes. Leave it off. Go to the image. An enhancement right now, it's set at 3, 4, 5. Hit noise reduction, set it from low to medium. Now it's at high. Leave it at low. Contrast. Contrast, leave it, you know, normal, mode 2, mode 1, where it is. Digital zoom, zoom in and out. That's 1.5. We do all sorts of things. We rotate the image, we can go to a twin mode. They all work, we've been through them all. Alright, customize, you can change all sorts of things. Assign scope buttons, for example. We'll run through those. First is freeze, second is the peripheral, third is the eye scan choice, and then fourth is the stopwatch. Go back. Scope enhancement, enable, disable, character display. Go to the system, you can change the date and time, where you store files, what display setting there is. We have it set to 16.9 right now. Eject the scope. And there are the peripherals. There's the USB printer control, so you could print if you wanted to. You know, from button 2 it is. You can set up the RS-232 cable network. You can go to another monitor, another display, you can go to a remote, whatever you want to do. All right, so no further ado, I think what we'll do is test the first, well, we'll turn the pump on, you'll hear it. All right, it's quiet, but heartbreaker, it's quiet. And it is pushing air out here. Okay. And then we'll shut the pump off. So this first scope, we'll back out here a little bit so you can see the screen. Alright, this first scope, it is an EC3490 TLI 3.2, and we will, it's got serial number H110607, it's really in good shape. Be sure to look at the images of everything on the website, because that's really where you'll see, you know, all the details. Aside from what you'll see now. So we're going to turn the lamp on. We already have the brightness all the way up. Crank that down a little bit. The zoom is at 1.5. You can change that. Set up image 1. Digital zoom off. 1.2, 2. And let's hit some buttons here. What do we got? That's one, so this is going to be a freeze. Freezes the image, and then it goes to the other image there. This would, number two would be a peripheral, you know, the printer or whatever. Print. But in this case, it clears it out. Three is the stopwatch. It must be hidden four, I think. Yeah, in the upper right-hand corner, hopefully you can see stopwatch is running. Stop that, and then if I can find the other button, there we go. So digital zoom, that's set to two. Eye scan, two. Eye scan, three. All the buttons work. It's really in good shape. All right, so we're gonna just move on to the next scope. This next scope is an EC3490TLI 3.2. Yeah. Okay, check the white balance, it says. Oh, white balance, there you go. Not sure about the serial number. Serial number H110606, and again, it's an EC3490TLI 3.2. Lamp is all the way. Lamp is in middle point, brightening it, dimming it. We'll change the exposure control to manual. That's manual. Change it back to auto. Right now it's in peak mode, average mode. Change the color balance here. We'll get it all blue. Now all red. Back it down. Okay, let's test the buttons. Should freeze an image here. Image frozen. This would print, but it's just going to send it away. And then this is going to start the stopwatch. And stop the stopwatch. And eye scan one, eye scan two, eye scan three. And I scan off. Okay, we're going to move on to the next scope then. It in. Send it on. Maybe it's a smaller scope. EG29-I10 3.2. individual zooms off. 1.2, 1.5, 2.0. Contrast is now normal. Mode 2. Noise reduction. Tilt to high. Fine. Enhancement. 1. That's terrible. 2. And 3. 4. That's probably good. Yeah, 6 is too much. So 4. That's good. Freeze image from here again. There you go. And let's unfreeze it from this button. Freeze it again. We would be printing it, but we're not going to, obviously. No printer is connected. There's your iScan 1, iScan 2, iScan 3, off, and then now we've got the stopwatch rolling. Stopwatch is still rolling. Stopwatch is off. Just in case I didn't do it. Serial number on this, I don't think I did. 811-4319. Mac is off. Oops. Last one done. It's an EC38 I10L. Set on iScan 1. Let's get rid of that. Turn the lamp on, maybe. There you go. Set up. Image 1.2, 1.5, 2.0. This is serial number A111760. And let's test the buttons. Freeze the image. Yep, frozen. Freeze, peripheral, if you're printing or not, it goes away. iScan 2, iScan 3, iScan is off, 1, 2, 3, creepy. You wouldn't like me when I'm angry. Off, and that's the wrong one. There goes the stopwatch. Okay. Again, I'm Andy Parker. Thank you so much for taking the time to watch the video. If there's anything we can do for you, please do let us know. We'd be very happy to have a video call or whatever you need to show you how this works. You're certainly welcome to come and inspect in person. Best way to reach me is 858-504-0440. It'll be on the screen. And then also andy@lucideq.com. That's andy@lucideq.com. That's sort of like our company. Lucid Equipment, just no equipment. Okay, have a great day. Thank you very much for watching.